Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. We've been contacted by some people asking us, what do you think about Halloween in Saudi? It's haram. That's it. Assalamualaikum. Khalas. Bye bye. I mean, like, what do you want? You're going to say halal? Or you want something else? You want us to say Saudi rebel? The leaders, they're evil, rebel against them, destroy your country like they destroyed Yemen and Libya. Haram, akhi. Are you waiting for me to tell you it's haram? Or you're going to say, no, the way you speak about the brothers who give da'wah, you should speak about the leaders. Then I tell you, brother, you're wrong. Either I have to follow you or follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you're looking for a singer, I'm not a singer. I'm a brother that spread the knowledge of Islam. I don't tell you what you're going to want me to tell you. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam taught us how to deal with the people innovation and misguidance, and he taught us how to deal with the Muslim leaders. So if you have a problem, you don't have a problem with me. You have a problem with the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, as Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, he said, look, Allah's messenger alayhi salatu wasalam taught us, of course, the authority, the Muslim leaders, to fight against the Khawarij. Even though he said, تَحْقِرُونَ صَلَاتَكُمْ مَعَ صَلَاتِهِمْ وَسِيَامَكُمْ مَعَ سِيَامِهِمْ. Even he mentioned that they recite Quran and they pray and so on. But he said to fight them and kill them, and they are the dogs of the hell. But this Ibn Taymiyyah statement is no madkhali. Ibn Taymiyyah, by the way, yeah, it's no madkhali. By the way, barakallahu fikum. It's no Wahhabi as well. As for the other hand, he said when he spoke about the evil leaders, he said hear and obey. Why? Look to the hikmah of the ulama. Look, because they understand the speech of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Because al-Khawarij, they want to corrupt people's aqidah. As for the leaders, they're corrupting people's dunya. They're not telling you this deen. They tell you this dunya. That's why some shuyukh who encouraged people to rebel against Ibn Mubarak, and I will mention them, Muhammad Hassan, Abu Ishaq al-Huwayni, and who's the other one? There's other few of them. They come out openly saying Ibn Mubarak is better than Morsi. Because Morsi is allowing Shia to come to Egypt, and that will corrupt people's aqidah. Morsi, he was protecting the deen. That's their statement, according to them, yeah? According to them. Inshallah, maybe the brothers can put the link in Arabic. We haven't translated it, but it's in Arabic. You can go check it. But the Shaykh, they said, Mubarak, he was not corrupting people's aqidah. Because the time of Ibn Mubarak, there was no Husayniyah, there was no Ilhad, atheism. You know, after Ibn Mubarak, Morsi's time, atheism started spreading, Shi'ism started spreading in Egypt. You know, there's a different topic, but the Shaykh is, barakallahu feekum, what happened in Saudi is haram. But now why, like this guy who's called Smile to Foolishness. His channel always, Saudi does something, picks on it. But hold a minute, you're from a country full of shirk. You have many followers. Why don't you clarify them about shirk, istighatha bi ghayrillah? About the shirk of Dubendis and not every Dubendis, by the way, but Brelwis and a lot of them in Asia. I believe you're Pakistani, you're Bengali, you're Indian. There's a lot of shirk. Speak about Tawheed and Sunnah. Teach your followers that will not have you, that you will decrease your numbers. Will decrease your numbers. But anything about Saudi, pick up on it. But if you want to pick something on Saudi, why don't you spread the goodness they do? The Quran, the competition of the Quran, they bring people around the world, the Muslims, and they pay them. They take care of them, you know, and they encourage people to memorize the Quran. Likewise, memorize in Sunnah. Likewise, they spend a lot of money to make it easy for the people of Hujjaj. I don't know about that one. You just speak on Halloween. And by the way, there was no Halloween festival. It was a festival of Riyadh. Sheikh Fawzan spoke out and guessed it. You know, and it's been happening since 2000. Barakallah feekum. But I don't know how come everyone starts talking about it now. And there's free mixing, which is haram, no doubt about that. Barakallah feekum, Halloween. But there was a festival of Riyadh. Some foolish Muslims, may Allah guide them. And Saudi, they're not angels, human beings like us, you know, they have desires. Among them, there will be munafiqoon, among them, there will be sinners, Muslim sinners. And if they are Muslim sinners, what we do? We ask Allah to guide them. Or we don't want to ask Allah to guide them because they're Saudis. They should not fall into sins. Barakallahu feekum. So we should not be behaving, having double standard, all right? And the person might say, but you have double standard with the du'at. Brother, I've already clarified that. Me, Quran with Sunnah. That's what I've challenged people for 7 years. Show me your opposing marriage self. And no one's coming out. Everyone, you can say, you give you money. They are kadabin. Alhamdulillah, that Allah humiliate them with their lies. The Shaykh, barakallahu feekum, now, Saudi have many goods. Khalija do a lot of goodness, alhamdulillah, for Islam and so on. Now, if they have some mistakes, why we go and glorify it as if you go to the country, that's what's happening. Alhamdulillah, some Shaykh spoke out and guess what happened. Barakallahu feekum. So, the way we speak about it, we hate it, we dislike it, we want people against it, but we do not encourage people to rebel, or we just spread the mistakes of the leaders, or maybe the leader himself doesn't know. Barakallahu feekum. He allowed this, what they call it, Halloween stuff, because it's from Satan. Wal'iyadu billah. And may Allah give tawfiq and guidance to the Muslims in Saudi and the Muslims around the world, because we don't want to see the Muslims kill each other. Why the enemies of Islam try to take over our countries. Barakallahu feekum. So what is the sunnah? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. I should start with the hadith first. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, when the Sahabi, there's many hadith, asked him, he said, oh, Messenger of Allah, I'm not going to ask about the leaders that do good, the meaning of the hadith. How should we deal with the leaders that do evil? He said, hate it. But do not remove your hand from the bay'ah. Mean, do not rebel. Do not rebel, hear and obey, but if they tell us do haram, there is no hear and obeying for them, but that should not be a leeway to to rebel as a justification for us to rebel against them. Also, the way of the munafiqun, they spread the mistakes. Us, we should not be spreading this type of fusq and ma'asi. Why? Because some Muslims out there think, oh, not just me, I'm doing it. There's many in Saudi doing it. And even with Saudis, bilad tawheed and sunnah, no doubts about that. And doesn't mean, when we say country of tawheed and sunnah, it means it's perfect. It means they make no mistakes. Tayyib, and Nabi alayhi salatu salam, his lifetime, Sahaba Khulafa Rashidin, was tawheed and sunnah. No one make mistakes at that time. There was no people for instances. There were, as been narrated in Bukhari and Muslim. So please don't mix between the two. Don't mix between the two. Because sometimes you can meet a brother, is sahibu sunnah tawheed, but you know he falls into zina wal'iyad billah. He doesn't mean the khalas, he's not a person of tawheed and sunnah. He's a mubtadi' now. Barakallahu feekum. So, what I've noticed is enemies of Saudis. Why? Not because Saudi is doing haram, sometimes Allah haram. No, because they know this country called tawheed, called sunnah, and they look for any mistakes to glorify that mistakes, and they leave off all the goodness they do for the Muslims around the world. You know, and these hizbis, when they need help for the masajid, where they contact Khalij. Mainly they contact Khalij or Saudi. Even though they always speak in a negative way about Saudi. Brother, go focus on shirk in your country first. In your country, there's shirk everywhere. Go make some videos. Keep you and Ali Dawah, Muhammad Hijab. Make video. I'm going to name you. If you care about Islam, true care, a lot of shirk is happening. In Egypt, there's a lot of shirk. Al-Hassan al-Badawi, make videos. Or you cooperate with Dubanis and Maturidis, who have big mistakes than this Muslim leader. What is happening in Saudi? Free mix, shirk and a bid'ah is worse. Sufyan al-Thawri said, Rahimahullah. He said, a bid'ah is more beloved to Satan than a sin. Subhanallah, look to the fiqh of the Salaf. So, it's haram. Barakallahu feekum. In Saudi, other than Saudi, it's haram. But what do you want us to do? You want Saudis to be dying in the sea, try to run away from their country because of civil war? Like what's happened in Syria and other countries? Alhamdulillah, their country has been looked after. Likewise, Khalij. So may Allah protect the Muslim countries. And may Allah bring people to rule us who are the best ones, righteous ones. And may Allah remove the evil ones from us and save us from the evil ones. And may Allah guide the Muslim leaders around the world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who follow Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam inwardly and outwardly. Wa sallallahu nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa sallam tasliman kathira. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Remove the